saw that. Revelio. Right. Natty told me what the two of you did.
Highwing's fine. I'm keeping an eye on her. She's safe, Poppy, I promise.
Good. Whatever the poachers are up to, I want Highwing far from it.
You said you had news about the poachers, and that some of it had to do with me.
It did. I overheard them talking in the Hogshead, and did you know that they have orders from Victor Rookwood to capture you on sight? Does this have anything to do with Rookwood and Harlow coming for you and the three broomsticks after the troll attack?
It does, somewhat. But at the moment, I'm more concerned about what else you heard the poachers are up to.
Fair enough. But I hope you'll let me know if I can be of help, especially after what you did for Highwing. Does the name Horntail Hall mean anything to you?
I'm afraid not. Why? What is it?
The poachers' best kept secret, apparently. The name came up twice, but they never went into detail. I also overheard one of them bragging about all the gold they're making, at the expense of innocent creatures, undoubtedly. The poachers spoke of this area, and I thought if we searched around a bit, it might give us clues as to what they're doing. If you ever meet my gran, this trip never happened.
Not to worry, Poppy. If I ever meet your gran, I shall not speak a word of this.
I normally tell her everything. She might be my best friend after Highwing, but she knows how I feel about the poachers. I think she worries I'll do something ill-advised.
Whatever gave her that idea?
This way.
An entire castle to roam, yet you choose to wander here.
Please, we don't want any trouble. We're simply passing through.
Do you take us for fools? That we do not notice more and more of your kind around here, in league with the poachers?
We aren't involved with them. If anything, we want to see them stopped.
I hope for your sake that is true. Our kind is swiftly losing patience with the poachers and those they work with.
He was certainly a charmer.
That could have gone worse. Centaurs aren't exactly fans of wizard kind, and the poachers aren't helping matters.
But why would he think that we had anything to do with poachers?
I did notice the poachers talking with a few villagers in Hogsmeade. I'm not sure why. Perhaps that's why the centaurs are suspicious. That's the third time I've seen a Dugbog behave that violently.
It seems that a lot of beasts have been more aggressive than usual lately.
I've noticed that too. It's almost like there's something in the water. This is odd.
What is it?
Not entirely sure, but look around. If the poachers were here, perhaps we can find out why.
Revelio.
Why wouldn't they take their cages with them when they left? Poor beasts. Still smoking. They can't have been gone long. This has got out of place in a poacher camp. I should tell Poppy about it.
Anything interesting?
Poachers were here. All sorts of evidence. But I found something else. It's goblin made.
I found goblin armor. Let's keep searching, but carefully. Merlin only knows what's going on here. I don't have a good feeling about this. How do goblin and poacher interests align?
Look, down there. Definitely poachers.
No creatures, though. So what are they doing out here?
Let's take a closer look.
They won't be happy to see us. Should we use disillusionment? Or perhaps a less discreet approach?
Hard to say from up here. Let's get a better lay of the land.
You can feed a beast or it can feed you, if you get my meaning.
Perhaps I'll scout around Felcroft for something to poach.
You want to talk of romance? Last time I saw you...
Nothing to budge in Aaron.
Have you heard from your family? Has either of your brothers come round to our way of thinking? Will they join us?
Nah, I say we go too far. The violence is gonna get us what we want. I say, if every last wizard is run through with a blade, then violence is gonna get me precisely what I want.
Sickens me to work alongside any of them. Don't know how Ramrock's stomach's being Neo Rookwood. Foul beast.
Not much longer now. So soon our necks will be out from under wizarding boots. Wizardkind will pay for what they've done.
Will only buy us a few seconds. Let's make them count.
What I wouldn't give to be a
Tavellia.
This way.
Helping ourselves standing here. Let's get to safety. We can sort this out later.
You're right. If there's anything the poachers are good at, it's tracking their prey. And right now, we're it. Be careful, won't you? I shall see you back at the castle.
Spell. After you've completed the required tasks, which I'm certain will prove useful in finishing your field guide, attend my class to learn the new spell.
Let me use it.
Afterwards, we will discuss your progress thus far in the term.
Confringo! Expelliarmus! Bombarda! Yeah.
Revelio.
Mother would like to speak with me. I believe she has learned about some of what we've been up to. I'm hoping she may be easier on me if you are there.
Can we meet at the Three Broomsticks? It may finally be safe since we rescued the dragon from Horntail Hall. Weasley asked me to find you.
Looking for the book Intermediate Transfiguration.
Professor Weasley asked me to, get something from that book. May I have it?
Did she now? I'll give you this book if you humor me by answering a few questions from my quiz.
Quiz?
Some people call bits of knowledge trivia. I would argue that no knowledge is trivial. Hence, I have created a small quiz just for fun, focusing mainly on the lore of the Wizarding World. None of the other students will try it, no matter how many times I ask. They all say they have enough with schoolwork. Ugh, they don't value knowledge the way I do. Surely you're interested. I'll even start you off with a few of my easiest questions.
If that's the only way I can convince you to give me that book, then let's get it over with.
Splendid! Just a few questions, and then I'll hand over this book. Let us begin. Before the invention of the Golden Snitch, which magical creature was used in a game of Quidditch?
The Golden Snidget.
Correct! The Snidget was first introduced to Quidditch in 1269 by a wizard named Barbarous Bragg. Sadly, they're thought to be extinct. Next question. Which potion is commonly referred to as Liquid Luck?
Felix Felicis.
Well done. Since it makes the drinker temporarily lucky, Felix Felicis is a banned substance in all organized competitions. The tale of the three brothers involves which magical artifacts?
The Deathly Hallows.
Beedle the Bard, the Deathly Hallows consists of the Elder Wand, the Resurrection Stone, and the Cloak of Invisibility. Which ball in Quidditch is the largest?
The Bludger.
I'm sorry, but the correct answer was the Quaffle. When a chaser throws the Quaffle through one of three hoops in a Quidditch match, their team is awarded 10 points. True or false? Polyjuice potion allows the drinker to change species.
False.
Correct. While Polyjuice potion can be used to change things such as age or race, it cannot be used to change species. Well, I suppose this has gone on long enough. I'll put the book back on the pedestal now. If you're inclined to test your knowledge again, I have plenty more questions I could ask you. I won't be giving you any more easy questions either. The next ones will be more difficult.
I don't have time for a quiz at the moment.
Let me know if you change your mind. I put the book back on the pedestal for you.
Revelio. Revelio ought to make quick work of this. Professor Weasley's tasks are complete. I should attend Transfiguration.
May be weary of hearing me say, is an exact science that can take a lifetime to master. But we needn't be daunted. Almost anything can be transformed if you can just perceive the potential within it. As I see in all of you, tremendous witches and wizards, every one of you. Or it could just be my eyesight. To do. easily done.
You wanted to discuss my progress so far this term, Professor.
I did. You seem to have had no trouble in getting up to speed. And frankly, excelling in your schoolwork this year.
Thank you, Professor. The extra assignments have been helpful.
As I suspected they would be. Now it seems you've been making good use of the opportunities presented by your field guide. Of course, the guide isn't the only measure of success. Deke tells me you captured a unicorn and brought it back to the Room of Requirement. Protecting so rare a beast is an accomplishment of which you can be quite proud.
Thank you, Professor.
I will say I'm especially impressed with all you've accomplished in light of the rumors of your extracurricular activities. Was your extended conversation with Mr. Ollivander after you'd obtained your wand, or subsequent search of the owlery, connected in any way to Professor Fig?
Professor Fig has encouraged me to explore when I can, in an effort to complete my field guide.
I see. I admire your penchant for learning, but do remember that your classwork and field guide are designed to educate you thoroughly. It'll be the end of the year in no time, and you'll want to be well prepared for your OWLs. I'll provide a final assessment at that time to ensure that you're ready for your exams. Until then, well done. You are dismissed.
Explain.
My plan with the helmet failed, but I have another idea. I think we may be able to find what we need at a goblin mine south of Hogwarts. Meet me there, and bring someone who speaks gobbledygook.
Travel broadens the mind.
Revelio. Oh, how fun and fly! You must try it.
that you speak Goldiegook?
I did. I mean, I do. Speak it. Is this to do with the goblin I saw you with in Hogsmeade?
It is. His name is Lodgok. We could use your help with something. He's waiting for me near a goblin mine. Would you be willing to help?
Of course. How exciting. I mean, well, might this be dangerous?
I think he simply wants to show me something that involves Gobbledygook. If it helps, he's a friend of Serona's.
Good to hear. Good to hear. If Serona trusts him, then I feel much better.
Lodgok is waiting. Shall we go?
Of course. I just want to check the pronunciation of a couple of key terms first. So I will meet you there.
Rebellion.
Is getting worse. If there is any chance that the relic from Slytherin's spellbook can help her, I must find it. I'm requesting your help. Meet me outside of Feldcroft. near the catacombs.
Look how fast they're.
I wonder who lives here.
Likewise. What can I help you with today?
What do you have for sale?
What are we looking for today? Thank you for stopping in. I appreciate it.
Let's see what's up your sleeve this time, Merlin.
Revelio.
Ah!
Revelio.
Wingardium Leviosa. Revelio. Now, my friend. Wingardium Leviosa. Lumos. Confringo. Revelio.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful.
Revelio!
What that means.
Confringo!
What are you up to now?
Revelio.
Come to stare at the fool, have you? There's poor Ig Haggerty, robbed by his own sister. She's robbed almost everyone now. So, who's the fool?
I'm not sure I know what you're talking about.
Then you're the only one who doesn't know about Catherine running off with that thief, Victor Rookwood and his lot. Good riddance, I said. Never thought she'd return to steal from me. Us, but I just know it was her. I want her caught and sent to Azkaban for stealing a prized family heirloom, sister or no.
I could keep an eye out for the thief, sir.
You? Nothing to be done by the likes of us. This is a job for the fine officer singer or some such authority. Besides, the thief, my sister, only strikes at night. Coward. Long past your bedtime.
What do you have for sale?
Okay.
Now that it's night, I ought to look into this thievery business for Mr. Haggerty.
It's, good luck for me you stopped by today. Thank you for your patronage. Glad you were able to stop by.
Revelio. Alohomora. More than they could carry. Lumos. Revelio.
Settled.
Revelio.
Need a sword like it.
Confringo!
You won't defeated our encampment.
Confringo!
I'll teach you nothing about you.
I should investigate.
Revelio. Catherine Haggerty after all. Revelio.
Bring me a dozen humans to battle. I'll take them all. Run the other way when they see me.
Okay.
Alohomora.
My mother used to say I was lazy.
I have some good news, Mr. Haggerty. I unmasked your thief.
Nothing to unmask, was there? We all know that the thief was my sister, Catherine.
Actually, sir, the thief was a niffler.
A what?
You know, small, furry, pilfering. I followed it to its lair.
Catelyn was the only one who knew how to get into our homes, where to find our treasures. I suppose, mangy little blighter. Well, if you found the Niffler's lair, as you say, you must have found my heirloom.
I found your heirloom, and I'll give it to you. For a price.
Huh? I suppose that's only fair. Very well, we'll call it a reward. Sounds more decent that way. Catherine's a disappointment for certain, but I never wanted to believe she was behind this. Now, thanks to you, I won't have to. What a strange world we live in. Suppose they can't send a niffler to Azkaban. At least I got my heirloom back.
Oh, how I love...
Excuse me, madam. I thought I heard you say something.
Yes, indeed. Talking to myself again, I find myself to be quite the engaging conversationalist since my husband passed. Madam Althea Twiddle, pleased to meet you.
Nice to meet you too, Madam Twiddle.
You know, you might be interested in this. You young people love this sort of thing. My husband often ruminated on the mysterious statue just outside our hamlet. Some sort of archaic puzzle involving vases, he would insist. I stumbled upon it today when I had a burst of energy and extended my morning constitutional a bit longer than usual.
An archaic puzzle? Sounds fascinating.
You see, I suspected you'd be interested, and wait till I tell you about the rumours surrounding this particular puzzle. My husband Greville insisted that solving the puzzle would reveal a magical challenge of sorts. The man was intrigued by everything. He was about to try and solve it himself when... Perhaps you could take a look. I'd be rather interested to hear what, if anything, you find.
If I happen to see it, I'll have a look.
Ah, the spirit of youth. I do hope you'll be able to solve the puzzle. If not for me, then in Greville's memory.
This could prove dangerous if I'm not careful. Mysterious and a bit unsettling. What to do?
You're here. Good.
Sebastian, that relic you mentioned...
I believe one of Slytherin's students stumbled upon the relic during an assignment to study sarcophagi in this catacomb. From what I read in a report by the student, they weren't permitted to take it with them, so I must assume it's still here. As I mentioned earlier, this relic grants its holder the power to reverse dark magic curses. If it's in this catacomb, I have to find it. For Anne. I need to see her.
I'm ready to explore the catacomb. Perhaps we can visit Anne when we've finished.
Perfect. By the way, Ominous has been asking about you. You didn't tell him what we were doing, did you?
I didn't, I promise.
Good. Ominous would be livid if he knew what we were about to do. I'll be interested to compare what lies inside to what I've read about this catacomb. I'm sure that foul smell is the scent of success. Try not to lose your nerve just yet. Insect free. Don't start. We're here for a reason.
Rebellion.
I'd say opening them all is justified. Finding a chest in an inconspicuous loft. Brilliant.
What
Watch your step. I need to slip there. I've read about catacombs that underwent expansion and led to random problems, often cave-ins.
And then were abandoned.
Exactly. We'll be fine.
Rebellion.
This is the sort of grave room I want to be buried in.
Surrounded by grandeur.
Grandeur and then some. Even an altar with a pile of bones. Lovely.
Bones outside a sarcophagus. Seems odd. There's something here by the altar.
What did you find?
Revelio.
Did you hear that?
We're in a cave. I assume eerie sounds come with the territory. Here. Revelio. We've made it this far, but clearly we have more to do. For the relic and conjuring barricades using bones.
Of course. The student's summary referenced the space beyond the great room, which means this can't be a dead end. I have the report if you want to have a look. Let's divide and conquer. You work on sorting out the bone barricades. I'll look around and see what we missed. Hold on to that diary entry. There may be more to it.
It does mention something else. It says their next assignment was learning the Imperius Curse.
Really? Interesting. We need to focus on moving beyond this room. But let me think for a moment.
Of course. I'll start to search for those barricades.
Brilliant. There's more to this than even I imagined. Look, bones stacked oddly on either side of this archway.
Leave no stone unturned, or, in this case, no bone.
If this archway's been barricaded, we can find a way through. I knew we'd get through. I felt it in my bones.
Nice. Revelio.
Thank you.
Amos. Lumos.
Mentions the Imperious Curse. I wouldn't be surprised if we're going to need it here. It's an unforgivable, but useful when you're outnumbered. Places the victim completely under the caster's control. So, if you'd like to learn Imperio, I can teach you.
It's probably wise to know the spell.
I couldn't agree more. A spell that could save your life shouldn't be unforgivable. You have a lot at stake. You have an ability that evidently no one's seen for centuries. Focus your wand movement. It's not an easy spell to master. There we go. Something troubling ahead. Be on your
Rebellion.
Guard.
Thank you.
barricade. Considering how well you did on the last one, this should be a cinch.
How gracious of you.
I try.
Revelio. Confringo.
This looks different than what we faced before. Now we're also dealing with rune symbols.
Imperium.
Summary described.
I doubt anyone's been here in quite some time.
Thank you.
Wingardium Leviosa! Rebellion.